From DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com, I'm Darren Marlar, and this is your Daily Dose of Weird News. Brought to you by Send Out Cards. You don't have to leave the house, you don't have to buy stamps, and you still get a physical card in the mail with whatever message you wish to send. Choose from the hundreds of existing cards or create one from scratch on your own, complete with your own pictures if you wish. Try it now absolutely free by visiting sendoutcards.com/weird. Be sure to remember that slash weird part. That's sendoutcards.com/weird. A Columbia University survey has found that 70% of 18 to 29-year-olds say that they had bought, copied, or downloaded unauthorized music, TV shows, or movies, compared with 46% of all adults who had done the same. Now, the older folks, it's not like they're more honest or anything, it's just that they're not as computer savvy as their kids. Move over, FOMO, and make room for FOBO. A study by cultural experts found that fear of being offline is the new fear of missing out, as 70% of respondents 13 through 24 said that they have to be connected no matter where they are. You know, I would make fun of these people, but, well, I did discover this story online, and I'm doing this show online, and you're probably listening online. So, CBS reports that the ratings for Sunday night's edition of 60 Minutes were the best the show has scored in a decade. Wow! Who knew so many people would be interested in that nice story about the basketball player from Greece? Despite protests, a Starbucks has opened in Yosemite National Park. Yeah, I'll have a double latte with just a hint of bear spray. A notorious prisoner in the UK recently started a rumble with prison guards because he was angry that he was not allowed a visit from his new wife. To make it harder for guards to take him down, the prisoner first smothered himself in butter, which instantly made him better tasting than any other food dishes originating in the UK. There is orange snow falling all over Eastern Europe, something that happens twice every decade or so, though it's a little more extreme this time around. It's likely the result of desert winds and the Sahara whipping up sand that has been combined with snow from Siberia. This year it appears more sand is entering the mix than is typical. Russia, Georgia, Bulgaria, Ukraine, Romania, and Moldova have all been experiencing it. We're still in a general agreement, though, that orange snow is still a whole heck of a lot better than yellow snow. According to a study of senior citizens, many people 80 years and older would prefer living as long as possible in their current state of health rather than having a shorter life in excellent health. Yeah, okay, whatever, Granny. Yeah, you want to put your pants on the outside of your underwear now, please? Coffee is good to the last drop at slashing the risk of cardiovascular diseases, Parkinson's, and Alzheimer's. American women who drank 1 to 3 cups of Java a day reduced their odds of getting the disease by 20% to 25%, according to Norwegian researchers. Says co-author of the study, Lena Frost Anderson, the findings suggest antioxidants could be a factor in reducing the risks of contracting a number of ailments. However, drinking more than 5 cups of coffee a day can negate those good effects. Aw, man, I was really excited there for a while until that whole 5 cups negate the good effects part. Dang it! If you want to boost your brain power, all you have to do is drink tea, according to a new study. Any kind of tea will do the trick, in fact. Black, green, hot, iced, as long as you drink lots of it, says scientists at the Douglas Hospital Research Center at McGill University in Montreal, Canada. Not only will it make you smarter, but tea will also fend off Alzheimer's disease and other forms of age-related dementia. Yeah, you know what? They said the same thing about coffee. And then they stripped the joy away by saying you'd only have 5 cups a day. Dancing with the Stars professionals Emma Slater and Sasha Farber are now husband and wife. They were married on Sunday. Now, if you're both professional dancers, do you still do the whole dollar dance thing at the wedding reception, or do you bump it up a bit and take credit cards? Jennifer Lopez and Alex Rodriguez are vacationing in France. Okay, I gotta ask, vacationing from what? New York Governor Cuomo went to a black church on Palm Sunday and told this joke. I'm a Catholic. Catholics basically believe the same thing as Baptists believe. We just do it without the rhythm. But we try, we try. We're not as without rhythm as our Jewish brothers and sisters. Wow. You know what? I've said it before. Comedy is hard. The world's largest cruise ship is getting ready to set sail. Royal Caribbean's Symphony of the Seas is 18 floors high, it's about the length of the Empire State Building, and can carry about 6,700 passengers. Its first cruise begins this weekend. The ship features include a laser tag arena, bionic bar where robots make drinks, a 10-story racing slide called Ultimate Abyss, rock climbing and ice skating. The ship will host a production of the Broadway hit Hairspray, and its sports bar will feature 30 big-screen TVs. You can also rent any movie ever made, except for Titanic and the Poseidon Adventure and A Perfect Storm. And a Minnesota teen had a setback in her attempt to get her driver's license after she crashed her car into the DMV building. And here, she was all worried about parallel parking. Driving is becoming so last century. Since the end of World War II, getting a driver's license has been a rite of passage for teens, but that is less and less the case. The share of people in their teens, 20s, and 30s with driver's licenses has dropped significantly over the past three decades, not just in the United States, also in some other wealthy nations with a high proportion of internet users, transportation researchers have found. Well, duh. I mean, how can you get a driver's license when you're busy texting and playing Candy Crush? Craigslist is getting rid of their personals section. That won't stop some people, though. They'll just go to the auto section and say, extra roomy, low mileage, make an offer. China may levy a 25% tariff on American pork. Well, you know, if you're going to have a tariff war, you might as well just go whole hog. Blockbuster founder Wayne Huizenga has died at the age of 80. I think he might believe in reincarnation, too, because the outside of his coffin had a label that said, Be Kind, Rewind. A company in China is keeping track of employees on business trips by requiring them to send selfies holding the day's local newspaper. After taking a selfie that clearly shows the newspaper's date, employees send the photo to a company chat group as proof that they have started their workday. This has proven much more difficult, though, for the younger, millennial employees, as it takes hundreds of poses, photos, hair flips, and filters to get the exact right one to post to begin the workday. In Rotorua, New Zealand, a 24-year-old man has admitted telling a woman that he had been forced to drink poison and would die unless she performed certain sexual acts on him within 48 hours. He'll be sentenced May 25th. The police summary of facts states the man went to the woman's home, red-faced and bent over holding his ribs, and told her he'd been beaten up and forced to drink a vial of toxin. He told her that he would die unless he didn't sweat it out within 48 hours. Well, she suggested that he go for a run, but he said that wouldn't work, as he had to sweat it out in a particular way. He told her there was no antidote, as the person who beat him up was flying overseas. Shortly after, she began getting emails from an unknown email address appearing to verify his story. The emails instructed her to perform sexual acts on the man four times and have sexual intercourse three times within the 48-hour period to exhaust the toxin from his system. The summary said the woman only consented because she believed the man's life was in danger. But following this 48 hours, the emails and threats continued, saying people she loved would be hurt if she didn't perform certain sexual acts with the man. The kinds of activity included performing the acts 3 to 7 times per day or until he fell asleep, as well as allowing the man to film it on his phone. The threats stated if she didn't comply, semi-naked photos of her would be posted on the internet. She was also promised a car and large quantities of money if she did as instructed. Yeah, sounds totally legit to me. Los Angeles is considering a proposal to provide housing for all the homeless. Well, that should do wonders for property values and tax rates. Congratulations to the People's Republic of California. Arizona's governor has ordered Uber to suspend the use of self-driving cars in the state. Why? The state is a huge desert. I mean, there's hardly anybody out there to run into. A Spice Girls animated film is said to be in the works. Seriously, come on, people. Who answered with that when asked, tell me what you want, what you really, really want? Harvard students can now report professors for offensive remarks made in class or that made them feel uncomfortable. There's also talk of changing the team mascot to the Fighting Snowflakes. Today's Daily Dose of Weird News was brought to you by Send Out Cards. You don't have to leave the house, you don't have to buy stamps, and still, you get a physical card in the mail with whatever message you wish to send. Choose from the hundreds of existing cards or create one of your own, complete with your own photos if you wish. Try it now absolutely free by visiting sendoutcards.com/weird. Remember the slash weird part. That's sendoutcards.com/weird. For Daily Dose of Weird News, I'm Darren Marlar, and I'll see you next time, Weirdos!